Are you listening?
What are all the questions, sir? Since I asked for 5 questions, okay. I'm going to ask 1 question. Okay. In Surah 33,
Jesus
Allah...
No, show respect. Listen.
In Surah 33, Allah prays. My question to all Muslims. While Allah is identified, creator of everyone, while Allah is identified... As a moderator, can you answer my question? In Surah 23, Allah is praying to someone.
Okay.
Okay? My question to you, who is Allah praying to? In Surah 33, Allah is praying. My question to you, as a Muslim, you believe Allah is one and only. Who is Allah praying to? Is there someone more powerful than Allah? Surah 33 verse 56, sorry.
What do you say?
Open your Qur'an.
I'm not coming here to try to debate you.
It's not the beginning of the Qur'an. It's not the Bible. It's not the Bible.
Tell me what the verse is.
No, the Bible is in the verse,
Allah is praying for Muhammad with the angels. My question is, who is Allah praying to? Who
is the... Which Qur'an do you... Because you obviously know about it, so tell me what it is.
Allah confirms salat upon him and his angels. All you who have believed, ask salat upon him and ask his. Allah is doing salat, salat is praying.
Do you know Arabic? How about the Bible?
Yeah. Believe it.
What you're saying is...
Allah confirms salat upon the prophet. Salat is dua. Allah is saying dua upon prophet with the, and the angel. So I'm asking who Allah is doing salat.
Whoever is giving you that interpretation.
I am moving on from you to him.
He wanted a question.
What is the salat?
Salat means several things in Arabic.
Yes.
It does not mean the prayer, it's just the prayer that we know. It means actually, it could mean dua as you supplication. Yes. It could mean praising someone. It could mean forgiveness even in some circumstances. So if you look at what the scholars, Ibn Kathir and others have said about it, they said, Inna Allah, when the Saluna ala Nabi, that means,
sorry, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
I'm just saying the Arabic question.
Okay.
I'm translating.
He says, when he says Allah is giving salawat on the Prophet, that means he is praising him, elevating his status, and forgiving him. When the angels give salawat on the Prophet, their salawat is different. They are.
Can you ask Allah to forgive the Prophet?
It means different. We ask Allah to send his mercy and
So you are telling me in Surah 33, Allah is simply sending his blessing to the Prophet. Okay?
He's giving him a blessing.
Okay, so.
Wait.
So, salat. How many means for the salat? He says there are lots of meaning of the salat. What is
as a word?
What is baraka?
If salat is
what is baraka in Arabic? What is baraka in Arabic?
Baraka.
Blessing. Okay. So there is in Arabic word. There is a word called baraka in Arabic, which means blessing. In Surah 33, it is used salat, okay? Which has been translated as... So, just a moment, let me just make my point, okay? So, salat used, and salat means is prayer. You are Arab speaker, and you know better than that. This man is Arab speaker. He already confirmed it means prayer, dua. So, I am asking the simple question that, since your definition of the salat disagrees with the Quran, can you give me any other verses in the Quran, the word salat used as a blessing?
Yes.
Yeah, give me the verse.
Yes. I'm not holding the whole memory of the Quran of me, but you ask if there are other verses. Yeah,
give me the verse.
Just say one sentence. I'm a humble man. I'm not very knowledgeable. I'm just an ordinary person. Okay. Are you hearing me out?
When you say salah combined with God, that means praying to God. When salah is combined to God, just that means totally just praying.
So what's your name?
Muhammad.
Okay. I hear what you're saying.
Let her say what she wants.
Okay.
She go for hours. That's okay.
So,
no problem.
I just want to make a very simple point, okay? If when the salat used for Allah, meaning changed from the prayer to blessings, okay? Can you provide that verse for me from the Quran, which tells us salat, when it is used for Allah, it means blessings.
Do you know what happens in the Bible? I'll tell you, it is there. I am not a memory, I don't have the memory of Quran in my head because I'm just an ordinary person. I'm not a scientist, okay?
So, you already told me that.
Can I just finish? I'm not saying I'm not knowledgeable.
That played with him.
This is that every Muslim person should know that every prophet, we say alayhi salam, okay? May the blessings, may the care be upon him. But Muhammad, because he's the last of them, he's the last pearl in that amazing necklace, he says alayhi salati wa salam. Okay, may the blessings, may the forgiveness be upon him, right? The way he lived his life, the way he sent us the last message, the message that ends all messages. So when Allah is asking us human beings to not pray for Muhammad, when we say alayhi salati wa salam, we do not pray for him. We say that the prophet, this prophet, all the other prophets will follow him as he is a leader to them, or he is, I'm not saying the best, because all the prophets in the eyes of God, that's a different perspective. We bless and we forgive Muhammad. So you human beings, you mankind, you should pray for us and say alayhi salatu wasalam. Pray not in the way of praying like kneeling to someone. You're actually told not to bow your head except to Allah.
Okay.
Not
so
to any other human.
You
being.
Made
I'm just
Muhammad.
Say one point.
That's your last sentence,
yeah.
Okay?
Okay. So when you say is it in any other verse, yes, Allah asked us to say alayhi salatu wasalam for the Nabi, for the Rasul, in many verses, not just this. And the full translation of the verse that you're holding, it holds actually many parts. He said, Inna Allahi wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala Rasul, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. So why didn't he ask about the angels praying for him? Why didn't he ask? Because it's not that. It's not a form of prayer.
Okay. So now let me just respond. You made lots of claims, okay? I'm just gonna pick some of them because I don't have time to respond all of them. My main question to you was, okay, this is the time for you to do a little bit research. Give me the verse from the Quran which tells you while salat means is praying, okay, when it is used for Allah, it is in the meaning of blessings. I'm gonna give you time that you can Google. Just a moment. You pass me to him. So now you need to wait. So now I'm gonna give you time. So you do the Google research and find that verse which can justify what you are saying. Okay? So take your time now.
I just wanna end this with one sentence that I tell
you. No, when you read the Quran,
I will take my time. But before that, when you read the Quran, don't read a verse or half a verse and take the meaning from it. Okay? There is a verse that says, "Wa la taqrabu as-salata wa antum sukara." Don't come near to the prayers. Some people will stop there, will be like, oh, it says don't come near to the prayers. But the rest of the verse says, "Wa antum sukara," while you're drunk. So don't read a verse just for you in the future. I'm gonna take my time.
Okay.
I'm coming back to you.
Thank you for reminding me that everything in the scripture, in the word of God, they need to be read in the context. I am sure I'm going to remind that to you when Muslims try to butcher my scripture while taking things out of the context. So now I'm giving you some time, and I want you to find the verse for me from the Quran where the Allah states, while blessing means is the prayer, when it is used in the context of Allah, it means, when the salat means is prayer, while it is used in the context of Allah, it is mean blessing. So I give you 2 minutes. Google should able to give enough for that 2 minutes.
I'm just going to open the Mus'haf.
Okay, so just wait.
You are only arguing.
So I'm giving you the time. So now your time starts. Give me the verse and then I'm going to comment on that. Wait.
He can refer to whoever he wants.
I am not a ball here. I have the questions as well. I want people to answer my questions. I don't come here to be tennis ball between the people.
It is.
That guy walked away. You passed me here, and then this man passed me this one.
Okay,
I know you've been out of kindness, but that I'm sorry that didn't work with Muslims at Speakers Forum. So now I want that. Wait.
You come into people that are just lay people. He said I'm a layman. We're laymen. No one argues. Go and speak to people who know.
Are you trying to be
no,
us?
No.
Hatun.
I'm sure that was not.
You know I have the answer to your
wait.
Do you know what it is, bro?
He doesn't have the answer.
He's searching. Wait.
I'm not a man that is instigating. I'm just a normal human being.
You don't need to get offended. He's like that always. Don't get offended. It's nothing personal.
I'm
going to give you time when I finish with this.
My phone is frozen. Just give me a second. My phone is frozen. I don't know what to
do. Even phone can't deal?
The same surah. Okay. I am number 43.
I said that straight up. And so we're trying and learning.
Okay. Can I look with you?
Just one. So my question to you was
another verse that Allah is saying the prayers on mankind, not to him. So it's come in a blessing, in a blessing way, not in a prayer way.
No, that wasn't my question.
That was your question.
So my question was to you, while you claim that salat, while salat means is prayer, dua, yet when it is used in the context of Allah, it means is blessing. It means baraka. Okay? He's Arabic speaker. He knows there is a Arabic word for blessing. Okay? So I ask you the question, show me from the Quran when Allah states, while the salat means is prayer, but if it is used in the context of Allah, it will mean blessing, it will mean baraka. So,
I'll show you what I found in less than 1 minute with a mobile that is not working. That verse, can you read it in English?
It is he who confirms salat upon you and his angels that he may bring you out of darkness into light. Okay. And ever is he to the believers merciful.
Okay, great. Can I say something? Okay. You did not look at that verse and say, oh, Allah prays for all mankind. He doesn't just pray for the Prophet. He says here, literally, that he prays, he and his angels who prays upon him.
No, just making sure it doesn't go in my bag.
He and his angels who pray. He and his angels pray for mankind, all of mankind. Does that mean Allah performs salah for all mankind? Does that mean that Allah bows to every person in mankind? No, in the tafsir of this ayah and in the other ayah and everything, when it's combined with Allah, in the tafsir, when you read the Quran, you need to read the tafsir. The tafsir is from the age of the Prophet till now, all the big scientists, all the big believers, and all, they will read it, and how they were taught it means they will write it. And hey, people, I am just a normal person. The strong Arabic is not my main language. I'm not good at it. I need to understand it. Someone will explain it to me, right? In the explanation of this, when Allah performs salah, him and his angels on all of mankind is giving his blessing to all of mankind. He's giving his forgiveness to all of mankind. Okay?
So now I'm gonna respond. Right.
So Muhammad, take you out from the darkness to the light. So how would salah? Can I hear you out? So just hear me out. So how can salah, normal salah, that Allah will put in us, or give us, or do for us, take us from the darkness to the light? So when Allah gave us His blessing, which is His word, which is the Quran, which is His risala to us, this is His blessing. This is the blessing that He's saying, I am giving you the blessing. I am praying for you. I'm not praying for you as, hey, I pray for you. I'm praying for you. I'm giving you all my blessings. That's how it sounds.
Thank you for that.
Thank you.
Couple of minutes explanation. As you noticed, you have not answered my question. My question was to you.
Can I repeat your question so you'd understand that I heard?
I want to understand.
I repeat the question.
Sir, you heard the question. You did not answer my question. There are two different things. So, where is it in the Quran? While salat means prayer, when it is used in for Allah, salat transformed from salat to baraka, which means blessings. Okay, so he just gave me another verse which I would use against him, because another verse. Sir, just a moment. I listened him well. Can I have a little bit respect from Muslims? That is another verse which confirms Allah is praying, and then that confirms my question. Who Allah is praying to? That's my question. So, are you trying? Let me just break up what you are trying to tell me. If in Arabic language there is a word for blessings, which is baraka. Baraka,
so many meanings.
Baraka, which
many
baraka,
so many
and lots of other meanings, lots of other meanings. Allah, He is all-knowing, all-wise, suddenly get His language wrong and His words wrong, and then He put that salat, which is prayer, My question to you, where is it in the Quran? Word salat is told to be used when it is in the context of Allah as a blessing, not a salat transformed from the salat to baraka. Where is that? You did not answer. You brought me another verse which again confirms Allah is praying to someone. That's my question. Who Allah is praying to?
So, you finished?
So,
let me, I'm just gonna ask a quick question.
Yeah, no.
Say to your son, I'm gonna pray.
Just one. So, I'm gonna ask my question,
I want
just one clear answer. Who is Allah salat doing salat?
Okay. No, I'm not answering that question, because the verse that I brought out, you're saying you're going to use against me, or you're going to use against anyone you debate with. You have the absolute right to actually use it, right? Because basically the Quran itself is like a scientific book that says, you want to prove me wrong, yeah, prove that Quran wrong. It's one of the books that says, try to write one sentence like the sentence that is written in it. So if you can actually prove one sentence that is wrong in the Quran, I myself will stop believing in it. Because I'm asked by Allah to test the book, to be like, this book is perfect, has no mistake. Didn't you ask yourself why that book was never fully translated? All the translations are explanations. They say it's not translations. Because Allah and His Prophet asked that book not to be translated and deal with, as in other language, as has done with the Bible, in different language. The main language of the Bible is not English, am I right? Just say yes or no. Am I right? No, I haven't finished.
You finished your point, I'm going to respond. You finish your point, I'm going to respond.
So, when you read it, in Arabic language, one word, different signs in it, one word could mean six meanings. That's one of the beauties of the language. So one word, just change some positions, could mean six meanings. So you are worried about a word that has two meanings and it combines with other things? If you say alam, alam, and then you change it, change the position of anything on it, it will be a totally different word. This is one of the beauties, this is one actually of the miracles of the book, that is written in a way that a human being mind could not write it. That's why when I tell you, when you read the Quran, you have to read the tafsir with it, because you are not a native Arabic speaker. I'm a native Arabic speaker. I do not understand fully some of the words there.
Okay. Now, let me respond.
I'm right to translate them wrong. I did not answer your question, so you don't need to say that I didn't
answer your question. Let me respond. Let me make some comments. First of all, my question still stands, who Allah is doing salat? Okay, that's my question. It still stands. You took all that time, give us lecture, yet failed to respond to the simple question. So, now, since you believe that one word in Quran means six different meanings, all those kind of things, in Arabic, all those kind of things, let's just put that in practice, okay? So, are you Arabic speaker?
No.
No, you are Arabic speaker.
Yes.
Okay? So, let me just put that in practice. Anyone has a pen or paper? Have you got pen or paper? Okay, you've got pen. Okay. You've got paper, is it? Okay. So, can you... So now we are going to practice, okay, to see if one word in Arabic also meaning six different words, okay? Can you write for me in Arabic, salat?
Can I ask someone to write?
No, just...
Handwriting in Arabic is really bad.
No,
you're going to keep this.
I am not asking.
I'm going to read it. I'm going to read it to you.
I'm not going to ask you that I'm going to put your writing to the museum.
No,
okay?
I can't
so
write it.
Just write it very simple, okay? Salat is only three different letters. Okay, can you just write salat for us? I'll move on to you. First, can you write for us?
Can I write salat for you?
Salat.
Yeah, I can write salat for you.
Arabic?
Yeah, in Arabic.
Yeah.
But we're not talking about that word.
Just a moment. Just write a little bit bigger so that we can examine it, okay? Salat in Arabic.
I feel like I'm in a handwriting test right now.
No worries, I'm not going to put on the museum.
Salat.
This is salat. Okay, let's confirm. Okay. In Arabic, can you write baraka for us?
Can I write baraka? Can I get what you're
saying? Just a moment.
Write baraka. His handwriting is rubbish, by the way.
Yeah, I have a really bad handwriting. I'm trying to say you that.
So, this is salat, this is baraka, okay? If you look at them, guys,
yes. They
are different consonantal letters.
Absolutely. Oh,
they are different consonantal letters, okay?
By the way, this is also birka, which means a lake.
So, at the time of Muhammad...
No, did you hear what I said?
I heard...
I wrote baraka, which means a lake, which is the same consonantal letters that is written in baraka.
That's my point. That's the point I'm going to make. So, at the time of Muhammad, you didn't have the dot for the consonantal letters. Okay? So, you didn't have the dot for the consonantal letters. Because of that, from one word, you could come up over 20 different words. I'll show you an example.
Can I add one more thing?
No, just one. I'm going
to
come to you. Just
the...
Just follow
me. Yeah.
What's going on?
I'm going to put my password. Can you not like look at it?
There's a camera everywhere, so I guess all the cameras will get your password.
الصلاة تأتي بعد دعاء دعاء أي دعاء يعني تدعو لما أقول لك إذا رحت أقول لك أنا مثلا الصلاة عندك لما تصلي على الشخص تدعي له
زي ما تقول لي ابنك هصلي لك مش هصلي لك بمعنى انك هتصلي صلاته هتعيلك
بس مش هتقتنع من زمان ما ما اعطيتهم مش هتقتنع
مش الموضوع
نتكلم
so okay this is your alphabet in 7th century consonantal letters without dots.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
8th century, you still don't have fully formed of Arabic letter, Arabic alphabet. Okay?
Okay.
You are all right with that. Only 6 Arabic alphabet can be understood clearly because of their dots. Okay? For rest 22 Arabic alphabet,
need dots.
You need dot to know.
No, you if need it dots. Is, I don't.
If
you need, as a foreigner reading Arabic, you
so
need dots.
Let me finish my point. Okay? So you need dots to read what is that letter for the consonantal letters. Okay? So.
I'm sorry, by the way.
Okay. Can you write for us salat without any dots?
Yeah, it's the same. Just take this out.
Just write it a little bit bigger.
Yeah, I'm not going to put
so
the dots.
You put the dot here. Why did you put that dot
there's
here?
There's no dot. That's an alif. Okay.
So daga alif.
When you have, we have this, it's
daga
like
alif. Okay, daga alif. Okay.
Can you handwriting. You need to daga, that.
Can you write baraka?
It's
without
the
any dots.
Only one dot.
So okay, just take the dot out. Just take the dot out. Okay. So.
Can I just, I need to go ahead. That was finish in 2 minutes just because I need to
okay.
Okay. You've got only 2 minutes.
Just I need to go ahead.
Okay.
Sorry, you need to go within 2 minutes.
Yeah, but that's okay.
So, while Arabic alphabet didn't have the consonantal dots at the time of Muhammad, you've got salat, prayer here, without dots in here, okay? Baraka.
No, this is baraka.
Yeah, sorry.
That's
yeah.
Okay.
This is salat, prayer, yep. Without dots. This is baraka without dots.
Yes.
Okay? Even if I take off my glasses, I can still see there are two different Arabic words.
Yes.
Okay?
Did I ever say without, that they mean the same
just
meaning?
Just a moment, sir. Just a moment. So, there are two different Arabic words,
yes.
Okay? One of them means prayer, other one means baraka. So, in 7th century, Allah knew what means blessings.
Oh, yeah.
In 7th century, Muhammad knew what means blessing.
Yes.
In 7th century, Allah knew what means prayer, Muhammad knew what means prayer. So, Allah had those two words even though you didn't have the consonantal dots.
That's right.
Okay?
That's
right. So, can you... So,
just
one second. Allah chooses to use the salat in the Quran.
Yes.
Okay? Which means Allah decided to not use the blessings in the Quran.
Yes.
First of all, can you just tell me the knowledge of Allah while he chooses the wrong word, yet you are trying to justify. Let me finish. Let me finish. I haven't finished.
I listened to you.
Okay. Now, that's what I'm trying to make my point,
okay.
And I want you to listen to me, okay? So, Allah had those two words in his hand, but he chooses to use Salat in Surah 33.
Right.
Yet today, you are trying to justify for me, no, that's baraka, that means blessing, okay? So, can you just tell me, how come you know much better than 7th century of Allah and 7th century of Muhammad? That's my first question.
Okay.
And the other points you made regarding the for you to being able to understand the Quran, even though you are Arabic speaker. Whose pen was this? The guy was here.
Yeah, it's my friend.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
Foreign.
So you made a statement. For even though you are Arab speakers, still you don't understand the Quran well. you need to go to the tafsir, which is the explanation, which is the explanation for the Quran. Quran has been put together late 7th century, yet you don't have even 7th century complete Quran. Tafsir, if you are talking about the, which tafsir are you talking about? Ibn Kathir?
Ibn
Kathir?
Right,
Ibn Kathir is 14th century book, okay? So you go to 14th century book, which tells you what Allah meant in 7th century. That's my first point.
That's your second point.
While in this topic.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. While Quran makes it very clear. Quran is well detailed. Quran is well explained, and there is no contradiction in it.
Exactly.
Why do you, as a Muslim, discredit the Quran and throw the Quran under the bus, try to justify the Quran by going to the other external writings? That's my other point. And also,
I need you to recap.
And then you said, Quran is perfect. There is no mistake in it.
Okay.
And then Quran gives you open mind to challenge that perfectness of it.
Great.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, can you just tell me why Quran makes a perfect and perfect historical mistakes regarding the death of Jesus, and Quran makes a biological mistakes regarding the embryology, all those kind of things, but my focus is the historical death of Jesus, and my second in this so-called perfect Quran as a perfect mistake that the Christian doctrine of God in the Quran, why Allah does not understand that. So from all the conversation you had, I picked only three topics.
Yeah.
I wanted to respond to them.
So your third question is about how does it have mistakes to the death of Jesus.
That was the last one, no?
The last one, yeah, the third one. The second one is how can we use the wrong word, or that's the first one?
That was the first one.
And what was the second one again? I just want to recap them so I can answer them like point by point.
My first question still stands on
wrong
who
word.
Is Allah praying to?
Yeah. And
so that's second. Second is the blessing and baraka. Are you trying to say Allah doesn't know
the third question is the
historical
wrong
mistakes. Yeah.
Historical mistakes. I'm not gonna go to the third question because that's a lecture for 2 hours. I'm not gonna go in it. I will
that
talk about it.
That is very essential to my Christian faith.
It is very
and
essential.
It is linked, and it is linked with the claim you made. So I picked only three questions. Please to respond
okay
to them.
Okay.
I
heard you out, so please hear me out. So the first word you said, he didn't use baraka in any other place, right? He did.
I didn't say that.
No, you said that. Actually,
I didn't
here,
say
why
that.
Why did he use salat
I
and
said,
never use baraka in the
no,
Quran?
No, I didn't
she
say
said that,
that.
Right?
So let me clarify okay that. In 7th century, there was a word for baraka. Allah knew it, Muhammad knew it.
Okay.
In 7th century, there was
adults.
A word. There was a word for salat. Allah knew it, Muhammad knew it.
Yeah.
Why in Surah 33, the two verses we look, Allah uses salat while you are translating that as a baraka?
Okay. First of all, when we talked at the beginning, we didn't say we translated as baraka. We said Allah gives the blessings, the thanks, the forgiveness, the everything to the mankind. We said right now from the tafsir, we didn't say it's baraka. And if you can ask anyone, we didn't say that salah here means fully baraka. It means when God says, in Allah wa malaikatu yusalluna ala rasul, Allah has forgiven, has blessed, has given his thanks, his everything to that human being who is the end of the all prophets. As
for
to
that
Markham, can I just like the second thing you asked about the dots. There were no dots in the language, and then the dots came by. How many accents you have in English? Accents.
Accents comes with the vowels.
How
in
many
7th century, you
no,
didn't
no,
have
no
the vowels.
Just answer me. How many
I'm not
accents
English
you have in English?
I'm not English.
No, in the language English.
I'm not English. I don't know how many accents.
How many accents you have in any language?
I don't know, like I'm not language.
A lot, right? A lot of accents in every language. When Arabic was speaking native by the people living in that area, they did not need dots because they, with their mind, can read and can understand fully what's written there. For me, I live in Africa. I'm way far away from that area. Centuries after, I am actually
based or originate as a foreigner, I speak another language, but Arabic will come to me later. So for me to understand and to differentiate between letters, I need the dots. So the dots is for me and you foreigners who don't know Arabic. So that's why it came later. That's why it wasn't
that.
I need to finish. You cannot. Right? So that's why the dots came later. The dots is for you and me, foreigners, to understand the difference in the language. But the native Arabic person who speaks all his life in strong Arabic language does not need dots. If any Arabic person here, you give him a sentence that doesn't have any dots, he will read it.
No. I'm not talking about the diacritical marks or vowels. I'm talking about the consonantal dots. For you to, I show you the graphs.
No,
for
I
you to know what is no, what is ba, la, what is ta, all those things, you need a dot to know
that's,
where the ba. Yeah.
True,
so
then.
You need it. You just said you don't need it.
No, I said I need
dialects,
it. Foreigner to Arabic.
Dialects are stepped into the world with the vowels. Okay. When there is a vowel, you need a dialect. In the 7th century, Muslims disagree with you what you are just saying. Just beware of that.
Muslims disagree with you?
In 7th century, yeah.
With what?
Muslims would disagree with you that you needed a dialect to know what were the consonantal letters. That wasn't the case in 7th century. Dialects entered the Islamic world when you had the vowels. So you know that better than me.
What?
Vowels.
What's that?
Like...
I don't know.
A, E, vowels.
Vowels,
the A, E, I, O, U.
All
right. Look, you need English speakers.
Yeah, but I'm Muslim.
تشكيلات باللغة العربية الفاوز.
Like tashkils, those ones.
Okay.
So, since that's discredit for you from the Islamic tradition, can you just...
It's not discredit. I cannot agree with that because... I just said to you that at the beginning they didn't need dots. They didn't need anything on the sentence to
let me just debunk that. Why did they? Why did they compile the Quran at the first place?
Don't take this.
No.
Why did? Why did?
Brother Mansour destroyed it. There's a video up there.
I just want to know why you worship three
why
dots.
Did,
this is what we should be talking about.
Why did?
No, that's the problem. Why don't
at the 7th
the
century?
Guys?
Yes.
Why did at the 7th century
too much.
People wrote down the Quran?
Why did in the 7th century? What?
People write down the Quran. Write it down.
So
they compile the Quran.
Or a fifth question.
No. So I'm just trying to debunk your claim that people, you don't need dots for the consonantal letters because people understood the dialects.
Again, I need dots. Arabic person, when the Quran came down to earth to us, did not need dots because the language was only in that area, speaking only by these people. They were masters in poetry. They were masters in writing it. That's why it was actually putting a challenge for them. It's giving them a challenge, trying to tell them, oh, you think you're great in poetry? You think that very hard language? I cannot write a book in it. A literate person who cannot read or write came out with a book.
That why can, are you misrepresenting your case?
I need to finish.
I'm going
to
let you finish.
I need to finish.
Yep.
I need to finish. So, at that time, they don't need dots, they don't need tashkil, they don't need anything. For us now, we took the language, not the Quran, we took the language, we made a lot of stuff with it. I have some words in my own country that is not even Arabic originated. It's originated from the occupancies that came to our country. But I call them Arabic language, but I'm not Arabic language. So when I read the Quran, I need the dots, I need the vowels, I need everything to read it right, okay? That's how I said, with one word, if we change the vowels, we can have 7 meanings. So that's why for me, to be able to read it, I need to read it right. If I were to copy the Quran,
If you did not need the dots,
I cannot be interrupted.
Can you just tell me why Quran was revealed in the first place in 7 different dialects?
You are giving me more questions.
In your case, according to Islamic tradition, Quran is revealed in 7 different ways.
You're not interested in
revealed in 7 different ways.
My line of thought. I will lose my line of thought.
Do not misrepresent your case. On the day of judgment, you are accountable to God for what you said and what you heard. According to Islamic tradition, Quran is compiled because people were struggling with the dialects. Okay? That shows they need... So when they saw this like this as a baraka, they didn't see this as a baraka.
Because, alhamdulillah, when the Islam expanded around the areas, a lot of foreigners came in. They needed dots to be able to read it.
7 centuries, 650s, the reason Uthman compiled the Quran, the reason 632.
You're going into several.
Abu Bakr right compiled the Quran. Just to clarifying and closing that topic, in 7th century, they needed dots. So
can I get
now.
Your name, ma'am?
Yeah, now.
Can I get your name?
Hatun.
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 Hatun. Please, you're just going into different circles right now.
No, I'm just correcting
you. No, you're so that's, just firing
that's
me and you're
homework for you. You can check it when you go home. So now, you can you respond to my second point?
Yeah. Can we join
He's gonna go. He's gonna go. Let him just finish, and then I'll talk to you.
I'm leaving in 50 seconds.
He's gonna leave, sir. He's gonna leave. Yeah. Let him to respond to my questions, and then you are around.
I'm just gonna finish this. You had main three questions. I cannot answer the historical part right now. If you need to really read it, and I'll just tell you one thing. You're saying mistakes about that person. Why would he give him praise, and why would he talk about him nicely from the beginning? Just think about that. You said they have a lot of mistakes in the Quran about his death, about
who?
Jesus' death.
Death of Jesus.
Yeah, which actually I don't believe in, right? But how would he praise that person from the beginning? How would he make them back great? How would he talk about his miracles and everything and then do a mistake against him? That's one thing, no.
Do you believe Jesus died? Do you believe Jesus died?
Can I finish?
Just one. Do you believe Jesus died? You don't believe Jesus died. Quran doesn't believe Jesus died either, anyway.
Can I finish?
Yeah, finish.
Right? As a story being told, as a bedtime story for a kid or for a human being wanting to believe in every natural superpower, I know how people will believe in it if they are born in a family that says that story, will be like, wow, that's a great story. A creature that really loves us and takes the sins over us. I would love that story if I heard it. But to be able to believe in something, you have to read everything, to understand everything. God gave us mind so we can go between the three religions, the million religions now, and decide what it makes sense to us, what makes sense to our heart. If you say that he makes mistakes against Jesus, the first thing when he talks about Jesus, he talks about his miracles, how is he blessed, how is he always followed by Ruh al-Qudus. That's okay. How is he always followed by Ruh al-Qudus? Why would he talk good of a man that he wants to make a mistake against? If you read the Quran, it's mostly stories about Moses, it's mostly stories about Jesus. Why would a book, if the man is writing a book for himself, Muhammad is writing a book talking about other people, why would he do that? Because he is the last pearl in a perfect necklace. He's the last pearl putting an end to all debates about religion. God gave us religion once, twice, third, and we mankind.
Why the Sunnis and Shias fighting?
Can I finish that?
Yeah, yeah.
God give us his word once and twice and three times, and we always mess it up, right? That's in the history, from Adam time till now, we always mess it up. He says, don't do that, and we do it. And he comes again, and he sends another person, and we say they are liars, right? When Jesus came, how many person called him a liar? How many person called him a liar?
Have you finished your point?
No, I haven't finished my point.
Finish
I'm
your point?
I'm actually going to end up, I'm going to leave. I'm really sorry because I'm actually a master's student. I have a thesis to work on. I really need to leave. I have a lot of places to go for before I go home. But what I'm saying to you, when you read a book, when I read the Bible, I don't read it from the eyes of hate. I read it as a word of God. And I read it as for a moment, for a brief moment, that I believe in it.
So,
and then, no,
as you read the Bible, as the word of God, that word of God tells you Jesus died on the cross.
Be honest.
While that word of God tells you Jesus died on the cross, your perfect Quran makes a huge mistake. Your perfect Quran makes a huge mistake and then tells people, guys, by the way, Jesus didn't die.
Please
so that is
Please
a huge, huge mistake. That's only that historical mistake.
You believe in judgment?
One of the big historical
mistakes. You'll be asked what you say.
Other mistake is, according to you, while Allah puts the salat today, you are trying to justify and then telling us Allah, Allah meant actually baraka. That just again destroys the Quran.
Please stop using these words when you describe the word of Allah, the word of God.
I don't believe Quran is the word of Allah.
Right.
I don't even believe in Allah.
When I write the thesis,
I look at the Quran from the critical.
We don't believe it.
Don't. But for respect for me.
Well, we respect you. That's what we're here talking about.
That's why I'm telling you.
We have to agree with
you. Yeah, but when you describe,
you can silence us.
No.
You can't silence us.
Don't silence. But use other words. When you describe, don't say.
damage the book, a wrong book. Don't say that. Because when I talk to you,
I can see you get offended. Just a moment. Why will you get offended for my comments on the Quran?
Did I say any comment about
it? I want you to just acknowledge something, okay?
No, I
while Quran,
we are getting in another point.
Okay, this is my last sentence. This is my last sentence, and then you make your way.
Okay.
While I acknowledge you are getting emotional with my claims on the Quran, I want you to remember, in that Quran, my God has been abused and accused.
Yes.
In that Quran, they give you wrong Jesus. You are abusing God, yet I am just commenting on the Quran, and you are getting sensitive on it.
The blind, so, who heals the sick, who wakens up
and
the dead.
That one gives you the eternal life.
Masters in?
I'm doing my master's.
Are you sure you want it to be mine?
That's useful.
Be finished.
God bless you.
Thank you.
I hope you
do you want your paperback as well?
And it's really good for you that you're reading. That's what we're asked for. Not to just believe what you're born in.
Exactly.
So,
read everything. I read the three religions. I thought about it by myself, not by my dad's or mum's decision.
Right.
I will do that with my son.
Yeah.
I will give him the three religions, read all of them.
Remember
go
the
with
dreams
what
that you have. God
you.
Comes to you in dreams.
Right?
Okay.
Just
be good.
So,
be good.
While your book abuses and accuses my Lord, I want you to acknowledge that it is only Lord Jesus Christ who gives you eternal life. From this conversation,
how would it abuse when it says,
he didn't die, it abuses. While it says he's just a prophet,
it abuses. So when it says he's on the right side of God, watching over us, he's been raised to the right side of God,
and he's still alive.
That's abuse.
Yeah, because he didn't die. It abuses Lord
Jesus. Death and resurrection reveals to us that there is life eternal.
Thank you very much for your time, Mohammed.
God bless. Let him go and get his master's degree. God bless you.
Yeah, make him move.